Hello, welcome to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading Songs of the Return, Volume 2, and I'll be reading through all these books. I'm in Yorvaskar, and I found this book in Yorvaskar. Songs of the Return, Volume 2, the first tale of Durimzu. By the way, there are at least, I believe, 56 books of these, but there's only 5 present in the game. Presumably because the other books have been lost to the passage of time. Anyway, onward. Our great Lord Iskramor, the harbinger of us all, did then send forth his 2 beloved sons, with him the only survivors of the brutalities of Sarthal, to seek out the bravest warriors of the land and mount the great return. Ingol and Ilgar, they were called, and they were known among Atmora as fine warriors with bright eyes and dawning futures. Ingol, the elder, was the brave strategist, bringing his learnings to bear on the battlefield that his enemies would be defeated before they even know the battle had begun. Ilgar, the younger, was possessed of an unwavering spirit that drove his singular prowess to overwhelming feats in war. Together, the mind and the arm, they were capable of sowing a destruction most thorough and glorious to any foe who stood before them. Before they parted ways to gather their crews, the 2 clasped arms and necks in the old fashion and laughed at the heavens for their stories to come. Young Ilgar then took to the massive shipyards of Ilkerfik at the southern point and commissioned 2 ships for himself and his brother. He would command the Durimzu and his brother the Harak, thus carrying the names of the 2 favorite stars of the heavens. The shipmaker's spirits had been suitably filled by Iskramor's tales of the savage elves, and they set about to berth ships that befit their noble homeland. Arrangements having been made, Ilgar set forth to the academies of honored soldiers, seeking out his most trusted friends and advisors to join him on the venture of the return. By now the stories of the new land to the south were spreading before him, and the mere emergence of his presence was enough to cause the finest warriors to lay down their present undertakings and follow him. So was he able to call to his side the great shield sisters, Froa and Grosta, who thought and spoke as one, and they brought with them the wise war teacher Adrimk, who first taught them to dance among the blades. She, in turn, mustered all the students at her command, whose names were not yet made, but some of whom would one day be known. Hermesker, who threw his shield, Erlak, who breathed fire, Ramth, the greater, Mercillion Ramth, and the far-sighted Uk, who would see the first of many dawns. On a day of final passage, when the many oared fleet would last see the distant green summers of Atmora, the brothers were near in their father's wake, as the freshly joined 500 would eagerly press onwards towards Tamriel. Ilgar could see his well-minded brother smiling from afar across the waves, and they shouted war cries to each other, longing for the soon day when their assembled crews would draw the treacherous elf blood into the ground, which they would now claim for their own rights. But kind ministrations were not to be taken lightly, and though her blessings gave wind to drive those brave sailors to their destiny, so too did her mighty tears fall to drive them apart. When the storm of separation first arose, young Ilgar had no fear, for his crew was strong and able, and their ship drove true through the forest of swells as though pulled by the rope of fate. When the skies cleared, and Ilgar glimpsed again, with new eyes, the land of his past and future home, he knew his brother's vessel was not within his horizon. The Durimzu, arriving late, drew forth onto the sands, and Ilgar rushed to his father to seek word of his brother. The great Iskramor, harbinger of us all, wept for his lost son, and sought comfort in the arms of his only remaining joy. The crew of the Harak became the first deaths among the 500, and Ilgar so enraged with love for his brother that his crew would soon be counted as first among the many noble and honored names in the Companions. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim, Songs of the Return, Volume 2.